In today's video, we're going to show you how a character can strike an enemy with a weapon. Here is a character holding a weapon. Currently, movement and attack functions are implemented in advance. And there is an object near the character, and I made it change color when the weapon touches it. The problem arises here, even if a character does not attack, it results in the object being attacked. It would be a good idea to activate the collider only when the character attacks. Let's see how to solve the problem. Select a character and open the animation window. Select an attack animation. If you cannot make any modifications or settings to the animation as in the current situation, duplicate only the animation element and reapply it to the attack animator. It looks good to have the collider turn on here, and the turn off timing here. So let's add two events. Now let's go to the script and put the code to handle the event. Make sure the manager player attack script is with the animator component. Otherwise, you can't use animation event. In this example, the game object pivot weapon R, which allows weapons to be mounted on the character's hand bone, is already attached and the weapon is set as a child of this game object. Since we used the box collider in our weapon, let's create a box collider variable, collider weapon. Then, let's create an additional game object variable to put the game object using the box collider into the variable. Now, let's write the code that gets the box collider component in the start method. First, add the weapon, the child object a pivot weapon R, to the variable. The getChild command gets objects according to their child sequence number. There is only one child of pivot weapon R, so you can set it to 0, the first of the index number. Now that we have the weapon stored in a variable, we just need to get that weapon's box collider component. Finally, since the character doesn't play the attack animation right away, I'm going to disable the weapon's collider. Now let's create a method to execute the animation event. Animation event only supports public methods. Simply create attack start and attack end methods. I will copy one line of code used in the start method and paste it into both methods. When the attack start method is executed, the box collider will be activated. And when the attack end method is executed, the box collider will be deactivated. Let's go back to the animation window. First, click on Event and choose the attack start method you just created. The last event selects the attack end method. Everything seems to be done. Shall we play? Even if a character approaches the object does not respond as before. You can see the color change as soon as the character hits the object. That's all for today's tutorial. Thank you, see you next time.